Hi there and welcome back, friends of A Thoughtful Gaming Experience. This is your host, Emmanuel Can, and we're in Circus Minor and fixing the clock of the Changing God Camp. First, let's ask about it some more. Struck a bargain, revered one. We would be in poor in spirit indeed if we did not honor our promises. Yet I see the clock remains unfixed, and you bring us no new knowledge of its workings. He bows regretfully. So we'll have to first repair that kind of strange clock. This complex machine towers over you. Its purpose is unclear, but the three circular faces set into the ground remind you of clocks. Something is wrong with the machine, however. It is partially transparent, shimmering in the air. When you look directly at it, the clock faces seem to show several different times at once. Humanoid silhouettes ripple beneath the central clock face. One places his hand against the face as though it were a glass wall. They seem to be watching you. Examine the machine. A towering mechanism wavers in the air, similar to Calisthenics. It appears to be in several states at once. Though all of the machine's states appear to be in the exact same location. You can't touch it either. Your hand passes right through the structure. And it gets blurry. We're in our own mind, probably. As you pull your hand away, a memory strikes you as powerfully as if someone took a club to your chest. You are working at the clock. It is no longer transparent, but perfectly solid. There is a noise behind you, so they've come, the three traitors. They think to surprise you, but through the powers of the clock you have first seen this moment. Three, maybe the three Tabard. There is the faintest sound of metal sliding against leather. You slap a hand on the central clock face, activating the clock's arcane powers. You're not sure what it will do to them, but it's better than what they'll do to you. There is a flash. Arcs of energy stretch out from the clock over your shoulders to your would-be attackers. You don't see what happens to them, but they quickly disappear along with their screams. As the last shreds of the memory fade, a swirl of energy passes through your body. Cold barbs prick every muscle. Suddenly, tidal forces arc from your body to three other locations in the cultist encampment. The machine recognized something inside you, or maybe vice versa. Either way, you have inadvertently activated several nearby devices. Examine it again. The machine wobbles in the air, seeming to be in several states at once. It makes you a little sick to look at it. Reach for the silhouetted figures. Your hand passes straight through the clock face, the figures, and the entire structure. It's as if the entire machine wasn't even there. Reach for them again. Your hand passes through them as before. You'll have to find some other way to get at them. Step away from the clock. And there are these other mechanisms here. Let's go through the first one. What's going on here? As you approach this device, Circus Minor changes around you. People are dressed differently and speak differently. Whole new structures appear, including an enormous building rising from the edge of the square. You look down at the device, a series of images flit across its surface. They don't appear related to the changes around you. You see faces of other people and places, all of them familiar. Look more closely at the changes around you. Circus Minor looks almost completely different. All the people are dressed strangely, and though they speak the truth, they use many terms and phrases that you don't understand. The square has changed as well. All of the tents are gone, the buildings are more colorful and less weathered. One building in particular rises from the edge of the square, a tower of purple rock some 50 stories high. A mural is painted on the side, though you can't see the details from here. It seems to be in the past, when all the buildings are less weathered. Examine the images on the surface of the device. As soon as you focus on them, You feel a warmth on your head where your tattoo is. The images respond to your thoughts, slowing and changing at your whim. It's something about your body that allows you to do this, which perhaps means that only you can even see the images. You immediately recognize the pictures as pieces of memory, specifically the three memories you saw back in the fathoms of your mind. Look at the memory in the underwater city first. The memory is recent. Two men, both with tattoos like your own, are in an underwater city searching for something. The denizens of the city chase them from their quarry and ultimately surround and capture them. As you review the memory, you get a strange feeling in your mind that you can only describe as a query. The device wants something from you. Suddenly you remember. The memories in the device are possibilities, but you can lock one of the memories here, so it is the only one that displays. You don't remember what purpose that served, though. Look at the changes around you again. Everyone is dressed strangely. The buildings are less weathered. If you had to guess, you'd say this is what Sega's cliffs looked like centuries ago. Well, so nothing changed in comparison to the normal thing. Now let's see what happens if we lock in the recent memory. Images of the two men in the underwater city are now the only images that play on the surface of this device. They search for something, are chased, and then are captured over and over again in an endless loop. As soon as the image is locked in place, a ribbon of energy stretches into the air, connecting the control device to the clock. Look at the changes. Nothing new. Unlock the memory from this device. With a mere thought, the images disappear. Or rather, they are joined by images of the other two memories. Pictures from all three memories play across the surface of this device, seemingly at random. Look at the memory in the Lush Valley. Somehow you know the memories from a long time ago, centuries ago probably. A man and a woman, both with tattoos like your own, are surveying a lush secluded valley for some purpose you cannot recall. Well, look at the memory of the city under siege. Somehow you know this memory is ancient. Might have occurred 1,000 years ago. A man and a young girl race through the streets of Sega's cliffs. All around them, the city is attacked by a terrible people, the Tabard, you recall. The man takes them to an ancient machine somewhere in the city, then he and the girl disappear. And that is what we will lock in. Like, with all the knowledge about these ancient machines, that's just what our protagonist wants. Lock it in. The images of the man and the girl are the only ones that play across the surface of the device. They run past the enemy soldiers and then disappear at the machine in an endless loop. Look around. Well, nothing changed. All right. And there we are. And it's the same in all these mechanisms here. Yeah, it is. So let's talk to the man again and ask them about changing God. We struck a bargain. All right. So we haven't repaired it, have we? Let's look at this last thing. Oh. We'll have to lock it maybe all on the same thing. Yeah, as you lock the third image, the air around the device trembles. The other devices in the square begin to glow as though they're about to do something. Just as suddenly, the glow on all three devices fades. The image you had locked to this device flickers, and then the three memories flit across its surface once more. The device seems to have reset itself. We can smash the device open. We can ask if that was what they wanted. So, was that what you wanted? Nope. Let's look at the clock again. Alright, the second possibility is to lock three different things in here. So here at the left, we'll lock the underwater city. And the middle one. Come on. Come on. We'll lock the lush valley. And with the third one. We'll lock the besieged city. Changes around us, or there is something different. Circus miners under attack. Squads of armored soldiers roam the streets, hunting and killing anyone they find. Mobs of people flee in terror, with only a few hapless souls trying and failing to fight them off. The soldiers are completely encased in jagged metal armor. You can't even tell if they're human. Looking beyond the carnage, the square in this vision looks wildly different. Many of the buildings that are on fire don't exist at all when you step away from the device, having been replaced by other structures. Leave it alone. Now, what does the big clock say? We'll just look at the stuff. Nope. Let's look at the quest description. These are main quests. Fallen to Earth. Fix the clock. Realign it with the present time. Seems like we just have to try out. Let's just lock the valley. Three times, maybe. And now, look closely at the changes around you. And it's under attack, all right. Lock the besieged city in. No. We'll lock the recent memory in this one. We'll lock the centuries old thing in the middle one. And ancient one to this. And we're going to look. This is a peace scene. We'll begin with the lush valley now here. I have absolutely no clue. First the lush valley, then the besieged city, and the underwater thing. All right. It would be the ancient one. Maybe we'll just use the recent one. Doesn't seem to be any logic in this. Look at the changes. It's centuries ago. All right, smash the device open. Can only failure. It shudders. A retry cost of 2. It's challenging now. Strike the machine several times. After a particularly mighty blow, a section near the base of the device caves in on itself and shattered pieces of synth spill out of the hole. Device goes dark. The images are gone, and so are the weird echoes of Circus Minor's past. You've definitely broken it. Around the cultist's encampment, the other two devices darken as well. But the clock becomes solid. It no longer appears to be in multiple time periods at once. As the clock returns to solidity, a strange thing happens to the sky. The sun races to the horizon and disappears. And Circus Minor is enveloped in darkness. Oddly, buildings in the distance, beyond the edges of the district, still appear sunlit. All right, we destroyed something. There we go. Maybe we are dead now.